Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today we're going to be looking at the fuel system on our 40 horsepower, 4-stroke EFI Mercury outboard engine. Now we know this thing's been sitting up for a while, so it's probably a big mess in there. And actually the mechanical fuel pump on the outside, the lift pump, it's not even on the machine anymore. So somebody was trying to figure this out and they gave up. Well, we're not going to give up. But let's step over to the table, look at the parts that I've assembled, and hopefully we can get this thing back running. So here we are. Basically, I assembled every different aspect of the fuel system, starting off with the mechanical fuel pump, then we've got a fuel filter, and a couple of different rebuild kits, depending on what I find inside that VST tank. So now that we've got all the parts assembled, let's dive over there, get off that cowling, and get to it. So with the cover off, it's obvious where we need to start. There should be a mechanical pump, what they call a lift pump, right here, and it is nowhere to be found. This is the way the engine arrived to me. So obviously somebody was doing a little bit of work on this and they got to this point and then they stopped, and then it sat up for a long time. But we need to go ahead and get it remounted, or a new one mounted, and then I fear, or what I project, is that the VST tank is going to be a mess, because like I said, this has been sitting for a while, and just the general smell that I've picked up on it from the different hoses is the fuel has been in there for a long time. But as I showed you on the table, I basically ordered every different scenario so we can get this thing back up and running. So let me grab the pump, we'll get it remounted. It's actually missing a hose that goes to the VST tank, and I have a length of hose for that. We'll get it remounted, go ahead and pull the VST tank, take it over to the teardown bench, pull it apart, and then we'll see what we have to work with. So our lines are as follows. This is actually a water line that passes through for fuel cooling. This is actually your input from the filter, and then this upper one, the smaller of the two, heads over to the VST tank. Now on the bottom side, a new pump already comes with the O-ring that we need. And then we're just going to get it bolted back up, get the lines connected, and this one actually uses zip ties to hold things in place. Now, if you're not going to use the OEM zip ties, make sure that you order some of high quality, because they're going to be in a very hot environment under this cowling. And the really cheap ones, they break down quicker, and then they're going to release. And fuel swirling around the inside of an enclosure, I think that would end poorly. So don't cheap out on the good stuff. Make sure that you actually buy things that will actually survive under and in this environment. Now the bolts that come from Mercury actually already have the thread locker ready to go. Now if you're reusing yours, or you're having to get a new set, just make sure that they are stainless, and then you want to add a little bit of red Loctite or thread locker before you do the installation on this. So that is one of our water lines, and the second one, incoming fuel. And outgoing. But we are going to go ahead and zip tie these ends. Get these tails cut off. Up top is where the incoming fuel line will be connected eventually. Then there's a couple of electrical connections, because there is actually an electrical pump inside of there, and that's what gives it the high pressure for the fuel injection system. So let's go ahead and get that connection pulled apart. Tell you, once these hoses, they get older, they kind of conform to the end of that barb, and they don't want to let go, because they're getting brittle. And that should be a early warning sign that it may be time to replace. Now look at that one. It actually had a split in it. And then it looks like we've got 2 8-millimeters. And at that point, we should be able to lift it up. I want to leave these lines connected, because they're actually a crimp type. And we're just going to disconnect from the bottom once we actually lift it up out of the cowling. 8-millimeter 5/16, if you're working out of a standard box. All right, guys, I told you there was only two bolts. It's actually three. There's one actually hidden down here. I was hoping that it just had a little bushing that it, or a grommet that it was sitting in that was holding it in place. No. There is one more 8mm bolt down at the bottom, so guess what? We need to drop off the lower cowling, but it's not that big of a deal. A few bolts on either side, and then it'll just peel off from either direction. All right, let's see if she's ready to shimmy off yet. Yep. To help remove some of these hoses, usually I'll just squeeze them to kind of try to break them loose, like this. That's a drain at the very bottom. We should be able to take it over to the teardown bench. Get those screws out and take a peek inside. Wonder what it's going to look like. Check out the fuel color when it comes out. It has a nice yellow tint. If you've never smelled stale fuel before, it's pungent. But that's not horrible. I've actually seen worse. Let's do take note of which hose went where. The one with the covering is going to be on this side. All right, last one. This one is actually the output going to the fuel injection system. So that's high pressure, and it is held in place by this piece here. What you do to remove it is actually push in on this red retaining clip and then pull. We'll attempt to remove these screws just with a regular screwdriver. If not, I may end up having to put it in the vise and then use an impact screwdriver to get it removed, because I really don't feel like stripping one of these and having to extract it. Let's see what we got. Oh yeah, she's going to be easy. But I have seen in several cases, especially saltwater outboards, where these get corroded and there's just no way to do it with a regular screwdriver. You have to use an impact to pop them loose. I don't want to disconnect these. I'm actually going to unbolt this from the body, and then it should all lift up together. I think that's the way I'd rather go. I've got the necessary tools to replace those, but why? Why disturb it if they don't need to be replaced? Not horrible, but we needed to go in there because that fuel pump had completely broken down. So what I'm going to do right now is spend a fair amount of time getting all this cleaned up. Then we'll evaluate, see if there's anything that we can reuse, and then replace as necessary. Now, I had the VST tank cleaned out fairly well, but I do want to go ahead and clean out this drain because I'm betting it stopped up. Now, one of the things that could have prevented some of this, now I realized the engine didn't run, but if you know you're not going to run your engine for a while, go ahead and put some fuel stabilizer in there, draw it into the system by running it for a few minutes, and then drain it all out. That way it's in the system and that has a better chance of staying ungunked, because obviously this has been sitting in fuel for a long time and, well, you see the results. But even if your engine's not running, go ahead and drain it, get as much fuel out of it as possible. That way you'll minimize the amount of damage that we're having to replace in here. Yeah, good to go. Now, let's take a look at the float, get it out of the way, look at the seat, see if we need to replace it or just the needle itself. Then we're going to address that pump. I'm looking at the tip of this needle, and it's actually bent a little bit, and it's pretty much as hard as a brick. I mean, this tip is actually made out of rubber, so it should have some flexibility in there. It is not broken yet, but it is getting closer. So we are going to go ahead and replace it. So let's go ahead and remove our pump. Be careful with these connections. Yeah. Keep in mind where they are. Black was over here in line with the output tube. Red was over here. So now let's go ahead and remove this plate, because I'll wager that there's debris on top of it, and we need to get all of that out. Yep, a little bit down there. Actually, I had two different pumps here because I wasn't sure which one was going to go in there. It is the older style, which fortunately I have. So we'll be sending that other one back. So the one we will be using basically just has this bottom O-ring and this little length of hose that actually goes into the top. So this is the one we're going to be after. This seat, like I said, we've already got one. Let's replace it. This one is probably okay, but with this other amount of damage, I'd rather just replace it all and be done with it. All right, we've got our seat in. We've got this rubber piece in for our fuel pump. Let's go ahead and get this plate back in place. We've got that screw started. Let's go ahead and get our float back in. There she goes. Then our electrical connections. Doing here is just bringing the spade clips back in, compressing them back down. That way they get a good grip on the connection. There we go. Well, that's it. Let's get it mounted to the base and then get this thing put back together. She's ready to go. I think everybody's going to reach and everybody's in the right direction. Let's go ahead and tighten these down. Well, all right, guys, that's pretty much going to wrap this up. Only thing I have to do now is put on that lower cowling, put on the cover, and she's ready to go out the door. Well, listen, if you need these or any other parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.